Hi, my name is Cautex, and in this video, I'll be talking about what is meant when people refer to a damage profile in World of Warcraft and why damage profiles matter. While there are many meanings for the word profile, in this context, we are using it to refer to something's shape or outline. So, putting two and two together, when we're talking about damage profiles, we're talking about the shape of the damage that is being done. But how does damage have a shape? The shape we're talking about here is that when you make a graph of the DPS that some spec is doing over time, that is, so the y-axis will be DPS and the x-axis will be time, the DPS that we're doing is not going to be a flat line. If we do 5,000 DPS overall, that doesn't mean that we're always going to be doing 5,000 damage every single second forever. We typically will do less DPS than that over a period of time, but then we're going to get some DPS cooldowns, and while those are up, we're going to do much more than 5,000 DPS. The shape of this graph is the damage profile. A spec's damage profile will describe when we will see spikes and dips in the graph, and how big those spikes and dips will be, and also how wide those spikes and dips will be. So again, a damage profile is the shape of the line that you will see when you graph a spec's DPS over the course of a fight. Now that we have a definition for what the heck a damage profile is, let's start to understand why they are the way that they are. It's important to understand that there are three variables that dictate a damage profile: the spec itself, the encounter, and time. Now, in reality, there is a fourth variable, which is the skill of the player. But usually when people are talking about damage profiles, they're doing it in a general, more abstract sense and are assuming perfect play or at least equal skill relative to all of the other specs. So let's go ahead and break down each of these three variables individually and talk about how they can impact a spec's damage profile. Broadly speaking, a spec can influence the shape of its damage profile in four ways: the baseline DPS of the spec with no cooldowns, the strength of that spec's cooldowns, the frequency of those cooldowns, and whether or not they can execute. Now, generally speaking, when you look at the graphs of these specs' DPS, you're going to see two distinct things: periodic spikes in DPS, followed by periods of lower but relatively consistent DPS where the line is mostly flat. What's important here is that some specs will have really large spikes with a lower baseline. When we see a graph like this, it tells us that that spec is capable of providing a lot of burst DPS, but outside of their cooldowns, they aren't able to provide all that much. Other specs might have a higher baseline, but less pronounced spikes when they use their cooldowns, meaning that they're not able to provide a ton of burst on demand, but are able to provide a lot of DPS regardless of the timing. Additionally, the width of the spike is going to be determined by how long the cooldown lasts, with longer duration cooldowns having a wider spike than shorter duration ones. Now, because of how the game gets balanced, there is typically going to be a relationship to how long the cooldowns of a spec are and the impact that they provide. Many classes and specs have their cooldowns on a 2 or 3 minute timer, which is why you might hear people talk about a given class being a 2 minute class or a 3 minute class. Generally speaking, if you look at the graphs of a 2 minute class and a 3 minute class who do the exact same DPS overall, you're going to see two things. First, the 2-minute class will have more spikes because, well, obviously their cooldowns are shorter, so they can use them more often. The second thing that you're likely going to see is that the graph of the 3-minute class damage will have higher spikes than the 2-minute class. Finally, some classes and specs have execute damage. That is, they have the ability to do more damage when the target is at low health. This changes the shape of the graph by making the right side of the graph higher than the left side. The reason why the right side goes up with execute damage is that as the fight progresses, the boss's health will get lower, and eventually we reach the execute phase and you can do extra DPS, making that period of time represented by the graph go up. Now, there are a lot of other nuanced details that you can analyze and compare when looking at the damage profiles of various specs, but in my opinion, these are the big ones. However, I do think that it's worth mentioning that each talent choice will have some amount of influence on the shape of the DPS graph. And understanding what each talent does to your class's damage profile is one of the things that will help you master that class or spec. The context that the damage is being done in has a significant effect on the shape of that damage. One of the more intuitive examples of how this works is that if there are two targets instead of one for the entire fight, then, well, all specs are going to have their DPS go up. However, some specs have tools that are particularly well-suited for hitting two targets. Other classes and specs might have AoE damage that scales better with more targets, so in a fight that has a lot of adds, they might do better than the class that is well-suited for a two-target cleave. Additionally, regardless of the number of adds, these adds could be very important to burst down, and this would benefit specs with burst AoE, or they could be relatively inconsequential and could just be passively cleaved, which would benefit classes with consistent AoE DPS. Another way that the encounter could change the shape of the graph is that it might require lots of movement, and some specs will suffer less from moving than others. The encounter could also have a burn phase where you need to stack as many cooldowns as possible in a small window to beat a damage check. In these scenarios, specs with stronger cooldowns are going to be able to provide more value than a spec with consistent DPS and weaker cooldowns. Another way that the fight can influence the shape of the damage profile is that the fight might have periods where it is immune to damage, which would make the line drop to zero because, well, again, the graph is measuring how much DPS is being done at that point in time. And if you can't do damage to the boss, well, then you're doing zero DPS. On the flip side, there might be a damage amp of some sort that makes you do increased damage, causing additional spikes on the graph or making the spikes that are there higher depending on their timing, which segues nicely into talking about time. But before we do that, I just want to reiterate that a damage profile is the shape of the line that you see when you graph DPS over time, and boss mechanics can affect how much DPS you do, and thus changing the shape. If we were able to just let these fights go on forever and just let each spec keep on DPSing and making a graph of that, each spec would end up with a very consistent pattern of when their DPS spikes, how high and for how long that spike is, how high their DPS is in between those spikes, and how far apart those spikes are. Now, in reality, obviously fights don't go on forever. How much time you have to DPS during an encounter will change the shape of the graph. So, for example, if you're a 3-minute class, you're going to be more effective on a fight that lasts 6 minutes and 30 seconds than you are on a fight that lasts 5 minutes and 30 seconds, because you will get another chance to use the full duration of your cooldowns. Now, if the encounter has a burn phase, then depending on when that occurs, that might mean that certain classes or specs are going to have to hold their cooldowns for that phase, whereas other specs with a different timing on their cooldowns will have it line up nicely. The interplay between the timings of when a spec is able to provide the most damage and when the fight requires the most amount of damage to be done is something that has a massive impact on how strong a given spec is for a fight. Because it's not always simply about what DPS you do overall, it's about when you're providing that DPS. And looking at damage profiles of specs can help you understand how strong a given spec will be during that encounter. The way I see it, there are two primary ways in which understanding damage profiles is useful. First, understanding the damage profile of your spec and how it relates to a given encounter can help you figure out how to maximize your DPS. Being able to know how each talent or certain stat priorities will change the profile of your damage will enable you to make the best decisions possible about how to set up your character going into the fight. Second, seeing the big picture of what makes a given class better than another on a particular encounter can help raid leaders develop group compositions or allocate DPS cooldowns so that they're able to provide damage when it is needed most. Being able to identify how to combine the various damage profiles of all the specs that you have available to you to most effectively meet all of the damage checks in an encounter while also maximizing DPS outside of these checks is a skill that will make you a better raid leader and help your group kill bosses in fewer attempts. Now I have a request to make of you. Communication is most effective when there is a shared understanding of what each term being used actually means. So if you see somebody talking about damage profiles and they're using the term incorrectly, or if you're talking about damage profiles to somebody and they don't seem to understand what you mean, then link them this video. But as always, I encourage you to tell me why my opinions are dumb and to point out all of the things that I should have mentioned but didn't. Lastly, I just want to say thank you for watching this video and subscribe for more.